Hello dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel Agri Adhyapak. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please do subscribe and join us on Telegram channel to get free materials and other updates. Links are in the description. We are providing online course at very affordable price. For more details, visit our website www.agriadhyapak.com and approach us through WhatsApp at 7845-7654-98. Thank you. Hello students, in this class I would like to explain on the topic called irrigation and the terms which are related to irrigation. So first of all, let us see the meaning or the definition of the irrigation. Irrigation is nothing but the artificial application of water to the field is called irrigation. So natural application of water is nothing but the precipitation or rainfall, but when we look at the irrigation, it is artificially applying to the field. So in irrigation, after we apply the irrigation, so what are the things will happen in the soil and what are the terms that we use, let us see. So once we apply the irrigation to the field, first step will take place is infiltration. Infiltration is nothing but the entry of the soil is called infiltration. So once water enter into the field, so that water will enter into the soil, that is called infiltration. So once water enter into the soil, then it will start vertical movement of the water into the soil, that we call percolation. So vertical or downward movement of water we call percolation. So not only that, water once enter into the soil, then it will move to the sidewards. So that sideward movement of water is called seepage. Sideward movement of water is called seepage. So let us see the meaning of leaching. Leaching is nothing but the when this water is entering into the soil and spreading all the sides, and along with that it will be moving to the downward layers of the soil. So along with that, the nutrients and the salts which are present in the soil will be get diluted into the water that we are applying into the soil, and they will be going towards the downward most layers of the soil, that we call leaching. That means the nutrients are the salts which are moving downward to the soil away from the root zone, still beyond the root zone, that we call leaching. So next one is runoff. Runoff is nothing but the excess water which is moving away from the soil surface to one place to the other place. That means from the saturated point, when soil is reaching to the saturated point, at that particular point all the macropores and micropores will be filled by the water and there will not be any excess acceptance of water by the soil. That is called saturated point. At that particular point, this runoff will take place. So excess movement of water from the topmost layer from one place to the other place, that movement we call runoff. Then the next one is life-saving irrigation. Life-saving irrigation is in other term we call contingency irrigation. So life-saving irrigation is nothing but when plant is facing moisture deficit, or when crop is facing the drought condition, or when plant is not having excess moisture to absorb, at that particular point when we give the irrigation at the peak point, that we call life-saving irrigation. And another saying also is there, the third irrigation that we are giving to the crop, that means first irrigation at the time of before sowing or at the time of sowing, and second irrigation on the third day when we are giving the life-saving irrigation. That means at the time of sowing we will be giving the irrigation, on third day we will be giving the another irrigation. That irrigation also we call life-saving irrigation. That means if we don't give the irrigation on third day after we plant the crop, crop will not sustain. So that's why third day irrigation is very, very important. That's why they named it as life-saving irrigation. So next let us come to the puddling. Puddling is nothing but we have seen the meaning of infiltration, percolation. So after entry the water into the soil, we should not allow water to the vertical movement or downward movement of water into the deeper layers of the soil. So we have to stop it. For that reason, they'll be doing the puddling. Puddling is nothing but the hardening the subsurface layer of the soil by stopping the downward movement of water. That is called puddling. This practice is especially done in rice crop. So with the help of tractor by the cage wheels. So the next one is core watering. Core watering is nothing but giving the first irrigation to the crop after sowing, giving the first irrigation to the crop is called core watering. Then let us see duty of water. So duty of water is nothing but the total quantity of water required for the crop for its growth till the harvesting. That amount of water we call duty of water. So I am repeating again, quantity of water required by the crop for its growth until the harvest is called duty of water. Then the base period. Base period is nothing but during the, for example, crop is going for 120 days, out of which how many days we are giving the irrigation. The total number of days are nothing but the base period. So this many days for sure we have to give irrigation. For example, in the rice field, more or less every day we'll be giving, but what are the days we are giving the irrigation, that is counted as base period. So the total days which we have given the irrigation during the crop period or growth period is called base period. Let's see the delta. Delta is nothing but the total depth of water required by the crop for its entire life is called delta. So this has to be measured in centimeters, not in millimeters, but it is in centimeters. That is very, very important blank. So total depth of water required by the crop for its growth and development is called delta. That means in vertical we have to measure how much depth for the entire life crop it required, maybe 10 centimeters or 20 centimeters. Based on the crop it will be varied. Then the next one is rostering or water regulation. Rostering is nothing but the distribution of water into the field is called rostering. By maybe drip irrigation or maybe any other surface irrigation or subsurface irrigation. In surface irrigation we are having different types like ridges and furrows, check basin, ring basin. So whatever it may be, how we are distributing the irrigation water into the field, that distribution is called rostering or water regulation. Then the next one is palko. Palko is nothing but the irrigation that we are giving to the crop before crop establishment is called palko. So the next one is irrigation requirement. So try to know the difference between core watering and palko irrigation. Then the next one is irrigation requirement. Irrigation requirement means, see here, total irrigation requirement for every crop will be required maybe some 600 mm or 400 mm. So when we look at this irrigation requirement, so IR equals to water requirement, that means total water requirement may be 600 or 400 mm, so minus effective rainfall in the crop during season, how much rainfall has come, plus groundwater, how much groundwater is available. For example, effective rainfall has come some 200 mm plus groundwater is available some 200 mm, so total 400 mm. And also water requirement is 600 mm, let us assume. So water requirement is 600 mm and effective rainfall has come 200 mm and groundwater availability is 200 mm, 200 plus 200, 400 mm. So total available requirement is only 600 mm. So out of which already 400 mm we have received through effective rainfall plus groundwater. So the leftover is just 200 mm. So this 200 mm we have to give in the form of irrigation. So this is called irrigation requirement. Then the next one is irrigation efficiency. So irrigation efficiency is nothing but the water stored in the soil for crop growth plus total water applied as irrigation into 100. That means for the crop, from the borewell, how much water we applied and how much water amount of water reached to the field, and in the field how much water is really stored for the crop growth and development. So we are not thinking about the how much water we are giving from the borewell, but we are thinking about how much water stored in the soil for crop growth and development. That is called water stored in the soil for crop growth divided by total water applied through irrigation. That means, for example, in the soil from the borewell we have applied 600 mm, just assume, but in the crop, I mean when we go to the field, in the soil just 400 mm is there. In between 200 mm might have lost through evaporation or because of other seepage losses and other losses, 200 mm might be lost. So here in the soil 400 mm has been stored and 600 mm is total water applied into 100. So this is the way how to know irrigation efficiency. Then the next one is irrigation period. Irrigation period is nothing but the net irrigation divided by peak use period. That means how much irrigation, actually gross irrigation is different from the net irrigation. Gross irrigation is total amount of water that we are applying, but net irrigation is ultimately how much amount of water really utilized by the plant and also for other purposes. So net irrigation divided by peak use period. Peak use period means at particular point crop will be using the water at peak stage. That's why we called irrigation requirement. So that is very important critical stages for the irrigation. So every crop will be having its own critical stages. That is nothing but the peak use period. So net irrigation by peak use period, that means in days we can write. So irrigation period equals to net irrigation by peak use period. Accordingly we can know what is the answer for the irrigation period. So these are the some of the terms which are very important and related to irrigation. Hope you like this class. If you like this class, please do like the video and do subscribe and share with your friends. If you'd like to join in our group, please text us through WhatsApp by the number 7845 765498. Thank you.